Hit a couple of records in the opening quarter, both for the longest touchdown pass, the 80-yard touchdown pass, as long as in NCAA Division II championship game history, and the 52-yard field goal is also the longest in NCAA Division II national championship history. As you see at the podium, we are joined by head coach Tony Anise, and to Coach Anise's left has brought two of his players, number 8, Austin Edwards, a 6'5", 275-pound junior defensive lineman, as well as slot receiver Deion Earls. He was number 4, a 5'8", 175-pound junior. Coach Anise, I know very disappointed in the outcome of today's ball game, but your team, you've talked about being gritty all year. Tell us about your comments about this contest.
Well, first off, thank you to McKinney ISD and everybody in this area. It's been an incredible experience for our guys. Unbelievable, spectacular work here at in McKinney, Texas. So it's beyond anything I thought it would be. So congratulations to McKinney and the Division II National Championship spectacle that they put on. In regards to the game, give Valdosta State all the credit in the world. You know, it's obviously a tough pill to swallow, watching them out there out in the middle of the field celebrating. I thought that as we approach this game, I thought that that would be us. And I had no doubts because of the trust and love I have for this team. I thought that we would be the team that won today. But Valdosta just played great. I mean, it was just an unbelievable effort by them. We couldn't get off the field. I don't know what they were on third down, maybe 18 for 20 or something incredible. I haven't looked at the stat sheet, but they just did a great job. Their quarterback was, both quarterbacks were just unbelievable. So if anybody wants to market an NCAA Division II ESPN feature, you just did an unbelievable job because that game was extraordinary. I told my team I'm really proud of them and I love them, and we fought just extraordinarily hard. And at the end, you know, I tell them it's my fault we lost because we probably should have had a better 2-point conversion play, something we practiced. So I always just say the players, when they win, it's them, and when we lose, it's me. And so it's our first loss of the year, 15-1 is pretty incredible. But Coach Bell and his staff did a great job, and all the credit goes to them. They were the better team today. And that's all it takes is the one day that you're the better team and you obviously can win the national championship.
Thank you, Coach Anise. We'll have further questions for you just a moment as we visit first with your student athletes. By the way, the 47 points scored by Ferris today was the most points ever scored by a losing team in the championship ball game. And again, what an effort by these young men from Ferris State. Again, Deion Earls on the end and Austin Edwards. Between Deion and Coach Anise, we'd like to open up the floor now for any questions you may have for the student athletes.
Austin, can you just talk about just the pressure that their quarterback and their offensive line put on your defense today?
They did a real good job on third down, and we got to do better getting off the field on third down. The offensive line, you know, they held up well. The quarterback, quick release, he was getting the ball off, and we just gotta have, you know, a little more heart on some of them plays, and it might be a different ball game. There's 2 points better than us, so yeah.
Deion, I know you've been playing for a long time, catching balls, doing different routes. That one pass. The one everyone's going to be talking about. Defensive back goes up, tries to catch it from going out of bounds, flings it back in, and then y'all end up getting the ball with, I believe it was, Joe Fortson coming up with that play. You ever seen anything like that before?
No, I never seen anything like that, but I was grateful I was on the field in that play, and I just seen it happen, and they said it's the replay. I said, we got to have that. So I was grateful that that happened for us.
Austin and Dion, I know you guys put a lot of work to get to this game. 15-1 still has to be a successful season for you guys, right?
Yeah, I mean, being second sucks. I mean, we had a great season. Came a long way from spring ball to camp. You know, I'm gonna say that we shocked myself honestly. The way we fought this whole season, our grit the whole season, winning on the road, winning when it's cold, winning no matter what conditions, with our facilities, whether the ground was hard or just figuring out a way to get it done. And yeah, it's a good season, but can always be better.
Yeah, I would say it was a great season. All I can say is I feel like now we know what it takes to get here. Now we got to finish. No, I don't believe that if there's anything we could have did better. I feel like 47 points is a lot, especially in a championship game. So I feel like we did a great job on offense all around.
Dion, can you talk about that last drive for you guys to, just the heart you showed to come down from 11 and, give yourself a chance at a two-point conversion to tie the game right there?
We felt confidence on offense the whole game. We had a great game plan from the coaches coming in, so we knew once we got the ball back, we was going to drive back down. So we had a lot of plays drawn up that we could have ran. We ran some great play calls. So, they put us in a position, players executed, and we was just one play short.
Austin, how fun is it to play a game like this? I mean, I know this isn't the result you want, but when it's all happening, how fun
is it? It was a great experience. Being in Texas, being back in Texas is a great feeling. The love from all the volunteers we had, the love of McKinney ISD, the love at our hotel, the love of just a random stranger seeing us with the T-shirt, coming up to us, wishing us good luck. It was a great feeling.
Question for Austin. You guys were able to come up with two touchdowns in the crucial stops. Obviously, you guys had a
we felt the heat, and it's either you bend, you break, or, you got to figure something out. And I just looked to everybody on the defense like, it's now or never. So everybody just stepped up, did their thing.
One final question. Now, let's again for the student athletes. This is for the student athletes, yes.
Both of y'all are juniors, presuming that y'all will have one more year at Ferris State. First championship for you guys. What kind of foundation did this set up for next year and possibly perhaps your revenge tour in trying to get back to the championship?
I feel as though our team is kind of young. We offensive line, we lose two starters. Outside, we lose Malik and Keandre. Still have Cy Barnett. You got some guys that want to step up, make plays. None of the slots leave. You got Jay Rue. You got Juice leaving. You got some running backs in. You got Portis leaving. You got some running backs that want to step up. Defense is young. I don't even think that many people are leaving on defense. And
two players.
So, I mean, like I said, I feel like we know what it takes to get here. Now we just got to finish. Bring that grit.
Yeah, this just sets a standard of what we need to do, because we, making it this far, we know what we need to do in the off season. We know what we need to do in the spring, and we can't just play to that standard. We got to go beyond it if we want to be better.
All right, thank you, Dion and Austin. We'll let you go head back to the locker room. But again, on behalf of all of us who watched that, a tie and 7 lead changes throughout the game. What a great ball game it was. I know it hurts now, but it was a great contest. Appreciate the performance you guys had. And again, just a reminder to the media, if there are others you would like to interview, or even these guys, that the locker rooms will be open for 30 minutes following this, that you got, starting now, that you, and you'll need to get with the Ferris State SID department. All right, let's go ahead, since you wanted a question for Coach Anise, let you go ahead and start that off.
Yeah, every week we practice that play. Give them credit. They did a good job with it. So, yeah, something we have a selection of probably 8 2-point conversion plays that we practice all the time. And we haven't used a 2-point conversion play this year, so that was the first one we pulled out. 0 for 1. Yes. Yeah, Jay Roos, the primary receiver, but Keandre's on the back of the end zone, and Javon Shaw is a former quarterback, All-State quarterback. And so, you know, it's kind of what they pulled with the little transcontinental thrown back to their quarterback. We expected that to happen. We had it covered and still let him run by us. You've got some great questions. I'm very impressed by you. But, you know, I've said it all along, just, you know, first off, they've internalized our mission and our core values, our faith, order, love, and discipline. And that those four, faith, order, love, and discipline, is in the fold, and we're basically intertwined together. And so that's what we teach our young men. And, you know, they never give in. They never quit. You know, we don't have games ever, and I mean ever, where we just let an opponent mow us down. And so I don't know why we have that attribute of being gritty and never giving in, but that's who we are. And, you know, even in this game, you know, we're very proud of our guys, and we love each other. I love the guys, and they love each other, and it's a big part of who we are and what we want to be. That's how we function. So it's a miraculous thing. Somebody's going to lose this game. I mean, everybody's going to say, goodness. I mean, it's sad for Ferris State, but if Valdosta State lost this game, it would be sad too, because it was just a great game, really a war of a game. And hopefully the Division II National Committee feels great about the two opponents that were here and what happened here with McKinney ISD, and the game was just incredible. It had to be awesome for people sitting back at home watching it. No, not really. Even when they were taking a knee, you know, the referee looked at me and says, "You're going to use your two timeouts?" I said, "Yeah." And, you know, in that situation, you know, I was telling our guys, listen, they're in the shotgun. I mean, this quarterback might fumble it, and let's not just stand around, you know. Next two plays, get ready, he's going to fumble it. And then the third play, he took the knee, and the game was over with. But I never really think we're going to lose. Never have, never will. Haven't been in many games where I thought, dang, we're going to lose this game. So I felt all along that we could get back in it. And, you know, it was one of those things where you didn't want to get down two scores. And when we did, you know, it made it tough, but I still believe we could do it. And finally got a couple stops. I mean, it was just so hard to get off the field, our defense off the field. It made us probably a little bit more conservative on offense, believe it or not, because I'm like, dang, we got to keep the ball out of their hands, you know. Let's run the ball a little bit and give our defense a rest, because if you look time of possession, I mean, we hardly even touched the ball in the first quarter, you know. That's one of the reasons, I guess, you don't run a gimmick play on the first play of the game to score a touchdown, because they drove down the field, held it, missed a field goal. We scored on one play, and then they, you know, they were on the field a long time. I always think scoring is a good thing, but in that case, maybe not.
Coach, finishing at 15-1 still has to be a successful season even after the heartbreaking loss.
Oh, absolutely. You know, I don't know how many people evaluate 15-1 as bad. I always just in my career, I'm 360 now. 300 wins, 60 losses, and 60 losses are like 60 deaths for me. So the 300 wins are we won. But so as a coach, you sit and analyze the losses more than you do the wins. I could tell you all a detail of every one of my 60 losses. I can't tell you details of 300 wins, but the 60 losses I can give you in detail. So, you know, that's how you, as a coach, you reflect on things. But, you know, from a program, I saw tears in grown men's eyes coming off that. It just, there's so many people that love their association with our program, and that makes me proud. And so I feel blessed to be able to coach the men I coach. I feel blessed to represent Ferris State University and all the fans and alums that came here and supported us. And it's been a great run. It's been a great run. Everybody wanted to be 16-0. It'd be the first time ever. Of course, yeah. We ran into a great team today, and you know, if I looked at the stats, they outplayed us. And if I kind of get the feel for the game, they outplayed us. They had 496 yards. We had 440. There's a lot of things they did that made it really tough on us today. And Coach Bell and his staff and his team deserve a lot of credit. They played a great game.
Coach Anise, again, we appreciate, as someone from North Texas, we appreciate you guys, the grit you guys showed during this championship game and the class you guys showed throughout the week as well. And I want to wish you the best of luck in the future, and thank you again for coming to our press conference.
Thank you. Thank you all.